Hey everybody, it's ManlyBadassHero, and welcome to Outlast, Part 4. Previously, we had just escaped this very snarky doctor after giving him his just desserts of death and snark. Stairs, up or down? Down it is. Simple enough answer. Items back here? Yeah, battery. Thank you. Patrick Petrina. Team Player Award. Employee of Markov Corp. I wonder why he has a gap like that in his room. Perhaps this whole place was locked down in siege and he had one there just for an emergency. That's odd. Someone move this table out. Oh, I see what they did. Huh, so matching some detail there. The desk was over here, and they just threw it for the wall over here. I wonder who's big enough to do that. Fuck it, I'm running.
Thank God you survived. I feared that secular maniac would carve you up like the others. Meet me outside. We're close now.
Never camper. I wonder where the guy who was cooking this lunch went. That's the real question, isn't it? Seems like he started cooking not long ago. He might have burned his meal. A lot of lockers in here. R. Traeger to P. Walsh, Markov Corps. Subject Annapurna, employee number 53, blah blah blah. Mr. Walsh, please accept the immediate resignation of orderly 531920. David Annapurna, and process him as a patient of Mount Massive to treat his persecutorial delusions. Treatment should continue until the time of his death. Thanks, buddy. Rick Traeger, Murkoff. So, my suspicions came true. I had a feeling that most of these patients weren't necessarily crazy. So Traeger, I guess he's been doing this for a while, that means. Any employee that started asking too many questions or was a liability, they obviously sent to him for his, I don't know, they're really experiments? I don't think he's really learning anything. When he took your fingers, I almost started thinking maybe he was planning to sell them or use them. like Raft Mond himself, or perhaps he was harvesting organs and selling them on the black market. Because he mentioned something about money or some kind of profit. Footsteps leading from this wheelchair went up. I should remember that for later. Just in case. Being a guy who needed a wheelchair, he climbed up here pretty well. Oh boy. I see we found our local pyromaniac.
I had to burn it. All of it. Murkoff took so much from us, used us, turned us into these things because nobody cares about a few forgotten lunatics. So let it burn. Burn the whole goddamn thing down. Get up. If you want to live, you can get up to the kitchen.
I'm not the only victim here. Not by a long shot. I watch a man wait to burn to death. The most painful death imaginable, rather than stay in this place. It says, turn on the sprinklers, huh? Not getting through that fire. I think I would have probably done a similar thing. You're probably pretty screwed in this place, to be honest. Burning it down, going with it, probably one of the nicer options. Really should patch up these fingers. Maybe a little band-aid or something. Let's go for this area first. It's always a bit of a puzzle to figure out what area is the optional one and which one's the one that's going to take you to the story path. Got my load, battery's getting low, quality's going down to the camera. See, I thought that was the story path, but cafeteria, laundry, baths. No, this is the optional, I think. No, no, it isn't. You're pretty much the most intact guy I've seen in a while. If you're seeing things, say something. There's no shame in psychopathological proximity stress disorder. Talk to your supervisor to get moved to the medical ward and get turned into a living experiment. Okay, so this was the optional area. No batteries. I don't think there's any. First turn on the two valves. Oh, he's with like two valves, two switches. Big guy. Big guy. Wait right here for him. I don't want to hide it. There's only one locker in there. Going for the gap. And if he decides to open that locker, I'm in a load of pain. Hey, guy. Slightly frustrated, I see. I was tempted to go for the gap and try to get behind him, but... yeah, he turned around pretty quickly. Hey, man! So you haven't learned how to get past these yet, huh? Yeah, just keep on walking. Damn, you asshole. Sometimes I think these guys actually smell you. There we go. Keep on walking. Keep on walking. Can he see me when I peek? I don't think so. No, he can't. Okay, that's good to know. I might have done this a little too early. Time if he decides to come and visit us. Two lockers. I don't like those odds. Some shelves. Okay, we can kind of around here. But nothing I'm looking for. No wonder. Oh, here it is. Okay, he's gotta go for at least one door. So we know if he's coming. We'll definitely hear it. Please don't make too much noise. Let me close that. Might aggro him. He's coming. Let's hope you're not very good at looking for shells, because I don't want to hide in a locker today. Come on, man. Okay, the way. Just Look the other way.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. That's a good girl. Oh shit.
Got a little too greedy.
Still there. Okay. He's leaving. Okay. Take a peek. Gotta reload the battery. Don't want to go out there without a full one.
You go. Oh shit! Not too greedy. Too greedy. Left or right, which do you choose? You choose not to see me. That's also a fine option. You know, I really do prefer that option, actually.
Like, I swear this guy went in here, and there's like no other way to get like out or in or anything, but I can't seem to find him. Is he behind that shelf? Nah, he's not behind that shelf. Only an idiot would hide out there in the open.
It's funny how that works.
Okay, so we got screwed up last time. We went out way too early. Now, I think I can look at him through these windows. No. Let's go a little bit lower. I'm trying to angle out.
Doopy doop, dippity doo da, dippity day.
What the fuck? He just won't leave.
Please go. Please stop patrolling in my immediate area. Thank you. If he comes here, I can quickly duck behind the other side. If he comes that way, I can duck between this side.
It's the best spot to be in. I forget where he is. I think he left. Okay. Oh shit. Oh shit.
Jesus Christ. Okay, he's leaving. Let's get out of here. Not that way. This way.
Okay. Where do I go from here? Where do I go from here?
There's nothing here I want.
Where do I go from here?
Oh no. Oh no. It's not the right way.
There we go.
You can't follow us in here anyway. I think. I'm gonna get in a very rude,
a dirty little duckling.
Jesus Christ. It really sucked to be an inmate in here. Let us leave, my friends!
No complaining now. We have to wash every little part.
Now, you can't get through this gap. The real question is he around the corner? There's only really one way to find out. I got both things on. If I can just get... Oh, shit! Okay. Hey, guy. Yeah. Even if this was real life, I'd probably still be acting smug if you couldn't get to that gap. Look at that loam, texture ass. Beautiful. I'll just be waiting for you to leave now. You just break that one door that you don't actually have to break, and I'll just be leaving. Door getting wet. I figured you'd need the shower anyway. That guy will be pissed. Anything survived this fire? Bodies. Batteries to in this area. Our friend left. Uh-oh. Don't like kitchens too much. Take back everything I ever thought about you being a friendly guy. You went for the wall. I can see he was a friendly guy. He just... I just spoke to him. He's like, there's some guy coming in here. He may kill me. I better attack first. Terrible demo program. It's finger licking good. As soon as I say that. I've said it before, but fuck this place. I've still got those fingers left. Batteries, batteries, no batteries. For some reason, that seems to aggro their door-breaking mechanism, so... MK Ultra program. Oh ho. Tell problem. For the past several months, Bluebird has been endeavoring to insert in by research, study, and instruction, and some practice what value, if any, can be derived from sleep induction and hypnotic techniques when applied to war and specific agency problems. Can we create by post-age control an action contrary to an individual's basic moral principles? Can we guarantee total amnesia under any and all conditions? Can we alter a person's personality? How long will it hold? What are full details on a sleep-inducing machine? Need more batteries. So I won't be getting any. Finally, we're outside. And it is absolutely pitch black. I have no idea where I'm going. Give a light, my son. This door needs a key. Is someone out here with me? What does it sound like? There's someone out here. Key. Batteries. Batteries. I don't even know your name, but I come to think of you as one of my blood, my Paul. I hope you don't mind, and I hope you don't indulge the vanity of self-pity, the fear that your suffering is more than others. We all must endure this, and you are nearly done. There's no way to heaven but by the cross, and every man needs another to help drive the nails in. I am here for you. I am waiting ahead.
Michael! Michael!
It's like I'm a moth. I don't really know where I'm going, I'm just kind of like going towards the flames. Perfectly good door. Perfectly good death trap. Oh, fuck! Still coming for me? I guess it's a good time to reload my batteries. You know, in real life, I would never ever go back in there. But this is a game. Curiosity killed the cat, you know. Excuse me, Wall Rider. Please don't suck out my soul. God help me. I think I've seen the Wall Rider. This is a terrible place to be. Top worst locations to go vacationing. So I went to Mount Massive Asylum and all I got was my fingers torn off. And then I got stalked by some freaking spirit thing. And a bunch of people tried to kill me. I'd give this location an F. I'm gonna go down real quick. I'm curious what's down there. Might just be if I fell. I can get back up with this. Yeah, that's what it is. I fell, I could get back up. I think that means. I feel like this whole area was just designed to waste my batteries. I can't imagine how someone would navigate this if they weren't stockpiling since the beginning. They just blew all their batteries to get to this point. Oh, time to break my legs! Flies?
Have to get out.
Father Martin, is that you?
I can see his ghost.
Need more batteries. You're our old friend. Look at that light. Now, am I walking towards you or am I walking away from you? That's the question. see if I need to get some lightning and get a good clear view of the whole area. I'm making noise, aren't I? That was not smart. Now I am stuck. There's anything else down there, but whatever it is, it's gone now. Ow, my legs! I'm tripping out. Vision all red. Can't see shit combined with broken legs. Park benches. My only savior. For Martin, you said we'd be meeting outside, you know, like not, you know, not in some hellhole. Figured we have like a nice conversation under the moonlight. Instead, you send me to this abomination. Jesus Christ. So much blood in the water. I could smell it. Like putting a pin in your mouth when you were a kid. The whispers are making more sense. I'm looking for static. It's like an itch. So we're going up there, definitely. I'm not looking forward to the female ward. I can already tell. We have only seen the tip of hell. The true horrors still await. Or maybe I'll be surprised.
You saw the fire, didn't you? You're beginning to understand, but not yet. Even Abraham had to cast his eyes to the ground. But soon! This way! Revelation is at hand!
More batteries. Thank you. red hue on this whole... Jesus Christ, man. Get a life.
What if I find out I was the villain all along? He was really the good guy. Someone's being grounded up.
The sound in the machine. Like the sound in my head when the wall rider appeared. I blink, and I see static. Something else. Something oily and dark, descending behind my eyelids. Watching me with organs, I can't imagine. But the sound is coming from the machine, too. From inside the walls. I know that sound.
These doors can only be open from the other side.
Hey, guy? This game has gone progressively dark as we went on. Big guy. Hello? The scary thing is I don't know where to run if he comes for me. This area is so dark I can't figure out a good general layout. This entire area is just pitch black.
It just destroys my entire spatial awareness.
Big guy.
If he's gonna ambush me, it's gonna be right here.
I was just hoping that, oh, like, look, there's some light. There's some light here, and then it's just gone. Just crush your hopes and dreams.
Break him. And then he will join the dark side of having no light.
Oh, little markers here.
Let's see, we can go ring around the rosy in this area. Reloading. I don't want to cover my ass. Down.
The Wall Rider, also known as the Alp, Mara, or Scrat, is a demonic creature of German origin that torments sleepers. They crouch on a sleeper's chest and crush the breath from him. The sleeper wakes terrified, paralyzed, and asphyxiating. The name Mara gives us the word nightmare. Sexual assaults by the demon are rare, but it has been known to drink the milk from the breasts of a sleeping woman, and the blood from the nipples of sleeping men.
Oh. Working towards.
I think these guys don't have good night eyes. You know, I thought you were the big guy, but, you know, you're just the little guy, so... I just hide out in plain open, since apparently you can't see me. Good. Oh, there we go. Maybe you can see me. Maybe you just don't care. Batteries! Two of them. Down or up, down or up. It's try out first. All paths lead to the same place. For being a female ward, I don't see any women. I'm about to eat those words, aren't I? I am very much gonna eat those words. This is not a bed I can hide under. Excuse me, fine sir, I'll be taking this. Project Paperclip. Nazi War Crimes Disclosure Act. The first paperclip provides a means of obtaining services of foreign specialists for specific assignments within the technical services of the Departments of Army, Navy, and Air Force. Project 63 is primarily a denial program, with utilization as a desirable feature. The aim of this program is to secure employment in the United States of certain preeminent German and Austrian specialists, thus denying their services to potential enemies. Blood. Batteries.
Nearly here. You can cross from the upper floors.
Batteries. One. Or water. A little bit more comfortable. Laundry chute needs free fuses. Oh boy. And that's it for Outlast Part 4. More of a transition chapter than anything else. We still haven't hit the female ward, and that's kind of been making me a bit suspenseful about what's actually gonna be in there. But we did get our first up-close glance at Wallrider, and, you know, I really don't know if he's just a literal Wallrider or if he's something else, but we'll see. Anyway, thank you all for watching, and stay tuned for Part 5 of Outlast.